So before going to the stages, some more clinical features are there. The patient can experience bleeding between the cycles. There will be pain during the urination, difficulty in urinating, pain during intercourse, as well as unexplained weight. And here you can read the general signs and symptoms which can occur in a cancer patient. And coming to the stages, there are mainly four stages. Stage one means the cancer is found only in uterus. Stage two, it will be found in uterus as well as in the cervix. Stage three means it can spread beyond the uterus and it can affect the pelvic area lymph nodes, the lymph nodes in the pelvic area also. But it will not affect the rectum as well as bladder. But in stage four, it will spread outside the pelvic region and affect the bladder, rectum, as well as distant parts. Coming to the management, generally it is treated with surgery, radiotherapy, or combination of these two. So early uterine cancer is treated with abdominal hysterectomy with bilateral salpingo-oophorectomy. So the similar surgery for ovarian cancer we have studied before. Surgery may be preceded for or followed by radiation therapy. So radiation therapy can be given as adjuvant therapy. So we can provide external as well as internal radiation therapy. So internal means placing radioactive isotope in an applicator and depositing this material directly into the uterus. So this radioactive isotope will be placing inside the uterus with the help of applicator. Commonly used applicator is tandem. Hormonal therapy as well as chemotherapy is most usually added in the stage 3 as well as stage 4 disease. So coming to the brachytherapy, variety of forms we can use to deliver the therapy, like wire, capsules, needles, tubes, and seeds. We have already completed the radiation therapy, so you can add more details from brachytherapy from that notes to this note. This is tandem, the most commonly used applicator to hold the radioactive isotope. And brachytherapy is used in the management of cervical as well as endometrial cancer. So here we will be using radium as well as cesium as isotopes. Preparation of brachytherapy, we have to empty the bladder as well as bowel. Why? Because in between the procedure, if the patient want to eliminate bowel, and if the patient is straining at the stool, the placed applicator will come out, or the displacement of the isotope will happen. So in order to prevent that, before the procedure itself, we have to provide a cleansing enema. And regarding the bladder, we have to insert a catheter, urinary catheter, so that we can prevent the distension of the bladder. So distension of the bladder will lead to exposure of this radioactive isotopes in the distended bladder. So to prevent that, we will empty the bladder. And applicators are inserted in the operating room. Can be inserted into endometrial cavity as well as vagina. So the applicator is secured with vaginal packing and is left in place for 24 to 72 hours. So we have to explain the patient all these things. So during treatment, the patient will be placed in a lead-lined private room and is absolute in bed rest. The presence of an intrauterine applicator produces uterine contraction. So whenever anything is there in the uterus, uterine muscles will try to contract to expel it. So here, same thing will happen. So as a result of this contraction, the patient will feel pain. So analgesic can be used. So when we are using the radiation therapy and the destruction is occurring to the cells, it will lead to foul-smelling discharge from the vagina. So use of deodorant is needed. Otherwise, the patient will be in discomfort. Other types of reactions like nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, malaise, all these things can be experienced by the patient.